ओलिगोसेक्राइड्स। माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, ओलिगोसेक्राइड्स आर दोज कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स दैट यील्ड 2 to 10 मोनोसेक्राइड्स ऑन हाइड्रोलिसिस। सो दे यील्ड 2 to 10 मोनोसेक्राइड्स एंड इफ दे विल यील्ड 2 मोनोसेक्राइड्स दे विल बी कॉल्ड एज डाइसेक्राइड्स। इफ दे विल यील्ड 3 मोनोसेक्राइड्स दे विल बी कॉल्ड एज ट्राइसेक्राइड एंड इफ अ ओलिगोसेक्राइड यील्ड्स 4 मोनोसेक्राइड्स देन दैट विल बी कॉल्ड एज द टेट्रासेक्राइड एंड सो ऑन। ओलिगोसेक्राइड्स आर अगेन क्रिस्टलाइन सॉलिड्स। दे आर ऑल्सो रिड्यूसिंग शुगर्स, एक्सेप्ट सुक्रोज। सो दैट इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट दैट द ओलिगोसेक्राइड्स आर ऑल्सो रिड्यूसिंग शुगर्स एक्सेप्ट सुक्रोज, बिकॉज इन केस ऑफ सुक्रोज द हेमी एसिटल एंड हेमी कीटल ग्रुप्स आर नॉट फ्री टू शो द रिड्यूसिंग प्रॉपर्टीज। What are the hemiacetal and hemiketal groups? I will try to make a separate video on this topic. Now, the oligosaccharides are less soluble in water as compared to the monosaccharides because as the size of the molecule increases, its solubility decreases and they are lesser sweet in taste as compared to the monosaccharides. Now, my dear students, the oligosaccharides on the basis of the number of monosaccharides that they yield on the hydrolysis, they can be classified into the disaccharides, trisaccharides, etc. But the most important of the oligosaccharides are the disaccharides. And among disaccharides, there are 3 examples that are commonly quoted. One is the sucrose, other is the maltose and third is the lactose. Dear students, sucrose is also called as cane sugar, maltose is also called as fruit sugar, or you may also call it as the malt sugar, and lactose may also be called as the milk sugar as it is present in the milk. The rich source of the sucrose is the sugar cane, sugar beet, and it is present in many fruits as well. The source of the maltose, they are basically fruits, and that of the lactose, that is the milk, so that's why it is called as the milk sugar. Now, my dear students, the sucrose is basically formed by the linkage of the glucose and fructose, and when sucrose is hydrolyzed, it gives glucose and fructose on hydrolysis. And maltose, that consists of 2 glucose units, and when it is hydrolyzed, it again gives the 2 glucose. And lactose is made up of glucose molecule and galactose molecule, and when it is hydrolyzed on hydrolysis, it will give glucose and galactose. And the molecular formula of all these 3 disaccharides, that is C12H22O11. So molecular formula of all these disaccharides is same, and that is C12H22O11. Now, among these 3 disaccharides, the one we are going to discuss, that is the sucrose. So let us slightly talk about the sucrose. Now, dear students, sucrose is a dextro rotatory sugar. It is naturally in the dextro rotatory form. And when this sucrose is hydrolyzed by using the enzyme invertase, then it gives glucose and fructose. And dear students, glucose formed is dextrorotatory here, while the fructose formed is levorotatory. And as the levorotatory action of the fructose dominates over the dextrorotatory action of the glucose, so that's why the overall mixture that will be the levorotatory. And dear students, sucrose is dextrorotatory, but after hydrolysis, it is converted into the mixture of glucose and fructose, which is overall levorotatory. So here the inversion of optical activity is seen. That's why this reaction is called as the inversion of sugar. Enzyme is called as the invertase. So this enzyme in its working sense is called as invertase, and this may also be called as the sucrase because it causes the hydrolysis of the sucrose. So this reaction is called as inversion of sugar just because of the reason that optical activity is inverted. Now my dear students, the sucrose is a non-reducing sugar. I have already mentioned, because the hemiacetal and hemiketal groups, they are not free to show the reducing property of the sucrose.